the Military College at Dehradun, and Lamartine College, Lucknow. I would like to use this opportunity to compliment both the teams for making it to this final stage. And I'm also deeply impressed by the involvement, participation, and interest of all the other teams who have made it through the different rounds as we have progressed in the debates over the last 3 days. You win some, you lose some. You will go home, each of you will do some kind of post-mortem on what could have been better, what went wrong, how we must improve ourselves for the next time. And that's exactly the way in which it should be. I do hope that you have enjoyed pitting your wits against those of your opponents over these last few days. And I am sure you will also, at the back of your mind, have this understanding that our minds are as good as the finest minds of people our age from different parts of the country. And that's one of the reasons why we meet up for programs of this sort. I would like you to go home with a tremendous sense of confidence and a re-establishment of your worth in yourself. That if you have been able to present arguments, get them recognized, get them applauded, get them sorted out, you have been able to achieve something. For this afternoon's program, we have with us 4 extremely eminent people from Lucknow. Eminence is not just by designation, but eminence is by interest, involvement, efficiency, professionalism. Our chairman this morning is Dr. Surabhi Sahai, and I would like you to warmly welcome her as Abhinav escorts ma'am onto the stage. Thank you, ma'am, and thank you, Abhinav. Dr. Sahai is herself a highly accomplished academic. She has been a Fulbright scholar. She is a gifted speaker, and she works with young people at perhaps the most crucial time of their life, which is when they are deciding careers. Professionally, she and her husband also run one of India's very well-known agency for training students for different competitive examinations called CP or CLAT Possible, which I'm sure you have heard of. Which is Loretto Conman, and I'm grateful that she has accepted our invitation to be here. It's been a bit of a problem, but that she is here is in itself evidence of the high regard that she has for our college. Mrs. Priyanka Malik is here with us this afternoon. She is, the Wellams people will be very happy with her because she is a Wellams girl, studied at Dehradun and is now married into Lucknow and is very much a part of the community of Lucknow and is involved in a series of different projects right across the city. We also have Mr. Suleiman Mehmoodabad, also known as the Raja of Mehmoodabad, who boys of Lamartinia must know, has been probably from the time of his birth, poor man, been looking after his estates, which I have been thoroughly watching with avid interest in the way in which the constitution of our country is being interpreted with reference in particular to the management of his estates. He is as Indian as the Ganga. But it is sometimes said that his estates belong to enemy property. He has the very, very difficult task of having to prove something which he shouldn't need to prove, which is his Indianness. And the fact that he is with us to listen to a debate which he has himself been a part of, he is a person of debate, for all the years that he has been around, is evidence once again to the quality of debating which we would like to see in school as well. I thank the three of them for being with us this afternoon. And I do hope that some of you boys will have an opportunity to speak with our judges and pick up from them what could have been better or what needs a little improvement. With that, I hand over to Dr. Sahai. She will make all announcements and will control the debate in her own particular style. Thank you, ma'am, for accepting us.
Hello. Thank you so much, Mr. McFarlane, for your kind words. You're so gracious. I am very happy to be chairing this debate today, and I welcome our three eminent judges. I'm so blessed to be in such eminent company, an august company. Ms. Renu Narula, she's been my teacher at Loreto Convent. I'll be very conscious of the fact that your glaring eyes on me. Mrs. Malik, Priyanka Malik, she's a dear friend, and I hope she will have a great time judging this debate today with us. And Mr. Suleiman Khan Mehmoodabad, Raja Sahab Mehmoodabad, I hope we all look forward to seeing a great debate over here today. And at the end of it, we'll have lots and lots of notes to share. I'm so very happy that some schools in Lucknow do this Cambridge style of debating, because I've always, at least I was introduced to it when I was in college. While in school, we never did this format of debating. And I thought this is a great, great format. And I'm so happy that Lamartinia has brought together all these schools. And they get to do this, an opportunity before they are suddenly put into the limelight in college. So that's very, very nice. And I've come here as a judge earlier. And that time, the gender equality was more valid. I'm so happy that today I am balancing the two boys' teams. Because last time I was here, there was a girls' team and a boys' team. But never mind. I hope we have risen above gender debates, at least in our schools. And it was a great competition in the initial rounds. I also do hope that this debating does not end here. These issues are taken up later in the media, where we see a travesty of what happens to debates on the popular news channels, as Sir rightly said. So it's going to be actually a great mercy to us to see good arguments, and I hope both the teams will be making arguments and not noise. The topic for today's debate is, this house believes that journalism is more about entertainment than news. So this is a very interesting topic considering the times we are living in these days, and even as we are speaking, the Prime Minister is also on the streets in Lucknow. I sure hope that he finds time to join us and, hear to all of you. The side proposing the motion is Lavatnya College, and the side is led by Vignesh Mehrotra. He'll be supported by Nilay Roy Chaudhary and Arnav Gurnani. Sorry. Thank you. I sure hope it was not Goswami. The fourth speaker here today is Aman Agarwal. Thank you so much, Lavatnya College. The side opposing the motion is Rashtriya Indian Military College, Dehradun, and it will be led by Cadet Tanmay Malik, who will be supported by Cadet Harshvardhan Singh and Dhruv Dhaiya, Cadet Dhruv Dhaiya. Most ably joined by the fourth speaker, Cadet Agam. I'll very briefly take you over the rules for this debate, especially for the judges. I hope both the teams are very well aware of the rules here. The principal speaker from each team shall be allowed 5 minutes to put forward his argument. The supporting speakers on either side shall be permitted 4 minutes each. In every case, a warning bell shall be rung 1 minute before the time for the speaker is over, and a second bell shall be rung to indicate that the speaker's time is up. Therefore, judges are requested to ignore anything which is said after the second bell is rung. After each speaker has presented his or her argument, a further 2 minutes shall be given for rebuttal. So each speaker shall be speaking for 5 minutes with a 2 minute rebuttal time. And this rebuttal shall consist of questions being asked by the opposing team. And during the rebuttal process, we really hope that the teams confine themselves to asking questions, and those questions are further asked only to the substance of the speech that immediately precedes it. No hypothetical cases, you know, you shall not presume this is what he may have said or did not say. A maximum of 2 questions may be asked. Cross-questioning shall not be permitted. Only the time taken to answer the question shall be taken into this 2 minutes. So I hope the timekeeper will surely bear that in mind. Although marks shall not be provided for the questions asked by the opposing speakers, the judges are requested to take into account the quality of the question posed when assessing the overall impression of the team. So during the discussion time, I'm sure the judges will take that into account. The speaker shall be permitted the use of flashcards and may refer to notes. However, the judges are requested to note that the continuous reading should be penalized. So I'm sure, and I hope no one shall be doing that over here today. After all the speakers have presented their arguments, the principal speaker on each side shall sum up the arguments for the team. The principal speaker of the opposition shall be allowed to sum up first. The supporting speaker shall take no part in summing up. However, they are allowed to assist the principal speaker with any notes or information that they provide. And the marks shall be allotted as follows. Content carries the maximum marks, 25 marks. Delivery, 5 marks. Refutation, which is answering the rebuttal questions, 10 points. Summing up, 10 points. And general impression, where the judges, I'm sure, shall include questions posed, intelligent questions asked, 10 points. Procedure for the debate, all right. So, shall we begin then? Are we all ready? We hope to look forward to a good debate here, and I hope we shall not debate the way we see on television. So I shall now invite upon the principal speaker of the proposition, Vignesh Mehrotra, to please take the dais.
Hello, check. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. The topic under fire for today's debate is that this house believes that journalism is more about entertainment than news. And I, as the principal speaker of side proposition, stand here firmly proposing the motion. Now, as the principal speaker, I'd like to fulfill my responsibility to the house by defining some of the key terms of the topic. The first one being journalism. the activity or profession of writing for newspapers, magazines, TV, in our generation, social media, or preparing information to be broadcast. Now let's look at the definition of entertainment. Entertainment means the action of providing amusement or enjoyment. And finally, what is the definition of news? Information produced, introduced recently for the first time, or not existing before. And news is required to be unchanged or unbiased. And that is where we come to the crux of today's debate. When we look at our current society, the way we are going to tackle this topic today is by going after three axes. The first one being the aspect and the evolution of social media and media. The next aspect being the evolution of society. And the third being the evolution of news. My second speaker will talk to you about the evolution of society. And my third speaker will talk to you about the evolution of news. Now coming to what I'll be talking about. We have to look at what media today is after. Media is not like what it was in the 1940s or before that. It isn't state-sponsored or it isn't sponsored by anyone. They have to look after their own sources of revenue. They have to look after their own earnings. And they have to produce something that will grab attention. If you look at our current generation, when we see photographs of any horrific incident in the newspapers, or if we see any horrific incident happening, you'll always notice that the media reports and shows the worst photographs. Why? You have to understand that humans as well are entertained a lot by violence. Humans are entertained by one thing that strikes. And that is why newspapers are trying to do what they are trying to do. They're trying to grab the attention of the people. They're trying to strike people where it hurts. And in doing so, they're making their news more about entertainment. Today, it all boils down to ratings. It isn't like the 1940s where any news report can just be about the facts. Today, unless there is a story baked into it, today, unless there is a context provided to it, today, unless there's a story that flows with it and interests and grabs the attention of the audience, till then, very honestly, ladies and gentlemen, people of our generation will not accept it, not view it, not recognize it, and most importantly, not understand it. And that is why it has almost become necessary for entertainment to be included in news. Let's take, for example, what our chairperson was also talking about, prime time debates, one of the most viewed activities on national television. First of all, they aren't talking about proper facts. What they are five very angry people arguing about opinions, basically claiming, no, sorry, your opinion is wrong. No, your opinion is wrong opinion. And it all boils down to them just having a fight on national television. And as it boils down, it is a very fundamental concept of human psychology that if you see a fight, at least in India, there are going to be 100 people surrounding that fight just to see what is going on. Why? Because that sells. The reason these shows are so obscenely popular, the reason Arnab Goswami is such an important public figure and is discussed at length on social media, in newspapers, everywhere, is because he is entertaining. Not because he provides accurate information, not because he provides news, not because he provides facts, but because he amuses the people. He provides enjoyment to the people. And that's the problem. We today, as Side Proposition, are not condoning this. What we here are talking about is whether that is a fact or not. Now, let's talk about a very solemn period in the past of our country, the partition. The partition was a very tumultuous time, and there were a lot of problems on all sides. And during that period, there were journalists from foreign countries which came and actually altered certain representations of activities and events that happened during that period. Now, that wasn't planned by our government. In fact, it harmed our government, it harmed our armies. How did it do so? It presented a worse image of what then it already was, and it also incited feelings of hatred amongst both sides. And you have to understand that our current modern generation is all about that. The BBC is considered the most respected news organization out there. It is considered the most reliable. Well, let's look at it. Out of the 10 hours they actually broadcast, 3 hours are about news, and the rest are about lifestyle choices, which hotel to stay at, which country to visit, and which food to eat. Why? Because entertainment sells. News doesn't sell as much as entertainment anymore. Take, for example, newspapers. Why are newspapers dying out? Why are newspapers being extinct? Because they aren't as entertaining as the other avenues. Now, ladies and gentlemen, to conclude, I'd just like to say that our media focuses on our society. It feeds off us. And that is why when our society starts demanding more entertainment, our media starts feeding them more entertainment. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, I am extremely proud to propose. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Vignesh. You presented your thoughts well, very structured. However, the judges, for the judges' information, Vignesh exceeded the time limit by 20 seconds. So Vignesh spoke about, he defined for us all the keywords of the topic. He brought into the debate the difference between media earlier, 1940s, and now, sensationalism and attention-seeking, opportunistic tendencies of the media today, and also supported these arguments with some examples. So I invite any questions for refutation that there may be. Yes.
Gentlemen speaker, you said how journalism grabs the attention of people. With the purpose of spreading news, aren't we going with a very parochial outlook?
Thank you so much, sir, for that question. Now, why is that question important? First of all, because that question is the topic for today's debate. What journalism is spreading these days isn't just news. What it is spreading these days is more of entertainment and less of news, which is what we're arguing about today, sir. I hope that answers your question. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Yes, we still have time.
Mr. Speaker, you talked about entertainment sells, but news doesn't. What kind of entertainment is sold by those journalists who are working on the border, who are working under serious conditions, under the ultimate threat of death?
Thank you, sir, for that question. Now, ladies and gentlemen, you have to understand that journalists are not just restricted to a particular category or a particular region. If you look at the scope of the entire journalists around the planet, they aren't restricted just to war-torn areas or restricted to border zones. The place where we get most of our news is from first world countries, the entertainment industry, the sports industry. Why? Because entertainment sells, and what these journalists sell are what is being accepted by the people. I hope that answers your question, sir. Thank you so much.
All right, we have so two questions have been asked. Thank you so much, Vignesh. For the future, may I request all of you to just drop the thank yous. Even if you don't thank the question, you have to answer it. I'm sure you know that. So we can really drop all the niceties in terms of the ones that are not necessary. So we'll just be nice to each other by not being not nice to each other. Thank you. All right. So with that, the principal speaker of the proposition has set the motion rolling and has given us lots and lots of thoughts to debate upon and deliberate upon during the proceedings of this debate. So may I now invite the principal speaker of the opposition, Cadet Tanmay Malik, to open the debate for his side. Thank you.
Check.
Yes, please.
3 scores and a decade after independence, or I may say 18 days just before the 71st Independence Day, today I beg your pardon. I beg your pardon, freedom fighters, because side proposition today chooses to neglect your efforts. Side proposition today chooses to neglect Hindustan, Kesari, Maratha, Harijan, Payam-e-Azadi, Sudha Varshan. We choose to neglect all these. With a heavy heart, good afternoon to one and all present here. Honorable jury, respected chairperson, my worthy opponents, and the august gathering. Today's topic in the debate says that this house believes that journalism is more about entertainment than news, and I, being a member of leader of the side opposition, stand here wholeheartedly and vehemently opposing the motion. Now, being the lead speaker of side opposition, I deem it as my prerogative to introduce to you the outlook of side opposition, the key definition, and then bring on my own arguments. So let's directly shoot at the definitions. First word is journalism. Always, it has already been talked about by the side proposition. I'll just say today, journalism is everything. Journalism is the profession of broadcasting information. It includes newspapers, magazines, radio, television, blogs, etc., etc. Now the second word is more. Quantifier for comparative degree, or I say the comparative degree of the word much. And now comes the third word. the most important word, the game changer word, and the word misclassified proposition, that is about. Ladies and gentlemen, when I say about, I mean to talk of the purpose. Let me give you a simple analogy. Today I stand here debating and they are sitting as of right now, we are debating. Once I ask what are the points in the judge's score sheet about, you tell me their purpose. There are two posters on my left and right. If I ask you what are these posters about, you tell me they are about Gulon Lee's quiz and Claude Martin. You do not tell me how much text is there and how much picture is there. So today's side proposition, please do not tell me how much entertainment is there or how much news is there. Tell me what is the purpose of journalism. Is that news or not? If yes, then we win the debate front face. Now let me give another clarification. Every advertisement is not entertainment. Advertisement spreads news. They spread news about the product. They spread news. They may be appealing, but yes, they spread news about the day. Yesterday was Guru Purnima. There was one full page about that in the newspaper. There are news about the birth anniversary or death anniversary of people on that particular day. Now, let me talk of another one term, or I may say the phrase. Lend me your ears, ladies and gentlemen. This is the ice age of journalism. With the ice age, I do not mean the mammoth age of their favorites or our favorite mammoth Manny. I talk of ice age. Today, this ice word has three words ingrained in it. I stands for information, C stands for communication, and E stands for entertainment. But the purpose, what is the purpose of journalism? That is news. I very well agree to the fact that entertainment has come into journalism, and entertainment is the mode of promotion. Entertainment increases the receptivity of the news, but the purpose is news, as entertainment promotes the news. Now, let me talk. We all are very well aware of the famous saying that pen is mightier than sword. I talk of Gaon connection here. Yes, I talk of Gaon connection. A Gaon connection, a newspaper from the very city of LMBC, from the very city of our elite chairperson and elite jury, from the very city of Lucknow. Nilesh Mishra, he's the man, ladies and gentlemen. He is the journalist, ladies and gentlemen, because he has started this newspaper, Gaon Connection, the most famous newspaper all over India in the rural areas. It talks of rural issues. It does not talk of entertainment. And there are its brothers and sisters, which are Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha TV channels too. Now, at last, let me give you the outlook of the side opposition before I rest my case. The second speaker will come up and talk to you and give you various examples. And then we'll talk of another term, that is infotainment. The third speaker will come up and then talk of real journalism. He'll talk of mouse journalism. And he'll tell you how journalism is more about news and not about entertainment. With this, I stand here wholeheartedly opposing the motion. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Cadet Malik. So you took the debate forward and again started by defining some of the keywords, stressing particularly on the word about and gave reasons for doing so, and also spoke about what all arguments that you disagreed with in the principal speaker of the proposition. So now I would like to invite questions from the proposition. Yes.
So in your speech, you talked about the purpose of these news of journalism, and you talked to Mr. Interjector for the second question. Mr. Interjector, in his speech, gave an example that there is an incident happens in the city and the news channel reports it with the worst pictures. With the worst pictures for the entertainment, so that news is caught by many more people. Once they look at those gory pictures, ghastly pictures, they see, oh, there's something real that has happened. I must look into this matter. And that is how entertainment spreads the news. But the purpose for that channel to bring that article on their television program was for the sole purpose of news here. And with this, I hope I answer you.
All right. Thank you so much, Karet Malik. And with that, we now go to the supporting speaker. So I invite the supporting speaker, the first supporting speaker of the proposition, Nilay Roy Chaudhary.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. The topic for today's debate states that this house believes that journalism is more about entertainment than news. While side opposition have stressed on the word about, they're right there. But what they need to understand is journalism is the method of spreading news. So they say that the method of spreading news is about news. That does not make sense. What we are trying to say is that the method of spreading news is more about entertainment. So journalism is more about entertainment than news. The method that journalists use today is entertainment to spread news, but they use what? They use more entertainment. So now, let me talk about the society aspect of journalism. The public nowadays doesn't want a simple, bland factual piece of information. What they want is their news to be spiced up. They do not want to know whether Donald Trump won the election or not. They want to know why he pronounced his country's name as United States of America. They want to know why this happened. They have no interest in knowing who won the election or why he won the election. They want to know the side. They want to know the entertaining part about it. Now, the media will provide the public with what it wants. This is how their ratings will increase. Now, if their ratings increase, this is how they will get their income. So let me compare the model of journalism to a watermelon. It is very similar. The seeds are the news. The flesh, the actual important part of the watermelon, is the entertaining story. And the casing around the watermelon is the rating of the news channel. So the rating of the news channel is what holds the watermelon together. And what comprises the watermelon is mainly the entertaining story of this today's journalism. So now, let me give you the example of Maria Sharapova. She made the news when she did not know who Sachin Tendulkar was, not because she won a Grand Slam title, but because she did not know who Sachin Tendulkar was, it became very important. Why? Because the Indian people took to Twitter to respond. That is what made it entertaining. Now, this is entertainment for the public. Now, 18 months later, when Maria Sharapova faced a ban for failing the doping test, these Indian people came back again. Why? Because it's entertainment for them. Now, they hit her back and they said that karma is what got her. It is because she did not know who Sachin Tendulkar was that she's facing a doping test, that she's facing a drug ban. And that is what entertains the public. Then that is what keeps the media running. Now, let us take the example of the Kardashian wedding. While some acts of violence were taking place across the country, the media was more focused on what was happening at that wedding. They wanted to cover that wedding for more than a month, while only for a few days was the act of violence mentioned. While we're talking about weddings, let us move to another example, the royal wedding. Where not just things directly related to the wedding, but things such as the Duchess's sister's backside were of more importance. People wanted to know how Pippa Middleton's backside looked while there were being school children being killed by gunmen. People want to know how a particular bride's sister's backside looks while people are being killed. Now I hope that I have proved to the house that people require entertainment more than the news. News just comes to them encased with entertainment. So for example, Prince William and Kate Middleton getting married is news. But Pippa Middleton's backside is entertainment for them. This news can definitely be explained through one line, that Kate Middleton and Prince William got married. But the Duchess's sister's backside definitely requires more elaboration. With that, I would like to rest my case. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Neela Chaudhary. So you carried the proposition's argument further and brought into the debate examples of Donald Trump. I was wondering when Trump would enter this debate. He has to be a part of everything, you see. You gave a lot of examples to support the cause. Watermelons, Kardashians, and backsides. So I must say the speech was thoroughly entertaining. And on the backside of your speech, may I please invite refutation. just 1 minute. No thank yous, please. Just say thank yous once and for all. Just answer the question.
Mr. Speaker talked about journalism is a method. You entertain us all by your flesh, by your melons, and by many things else. But don't you think it is no less than creating a willing suspension of disbelief exactly the way always did in the rhyme of Ancient Mariner? Isn't journalism a lot more than what you thought?
Sorry, sir, could you please repeat your question? I didn't understand, sir. I didn't hear a part of your question properly.
Just push, come closer to the mic. I think just push the mic.
Mr. Speaker, you talked about journalism is a method. Isn't journalism a lot more than that?
If journalism is a method, it is a method. Journalism is definitely a method of spreading news. Spreading the news is what is a lot more that you're talking about. Journalism is just a way to spread news. We have different ways of spreading. There are very different ways of spreading. There can be advertisements, there can be reports, there can be interviews. These are all different methods of spreading the news. There can be television broadcasts. But journalism is just one method of spreading news, and what side proposition today has to prove to the House is that the method of spreading news today is more about entertainment than it is about the news. Thank you.
Yes, please.
Check.
Mr. Speaker, you said the news about Maria Sharapova not knowing the name of Sachin Tendulkar was emphasized more. So are you telling me that all the newspaper readers today know Maria Sharapova as the woman who didn't know Sachin Tendulkar, or know her as the woman who won Grand Slam and is known as one of the greatest tennis players in the world? Please comment. Maria Sharapova being the greatest tennis player of all time, whatever it is a fact. That is not news. Well, Maria Sharapova not knowing Sachin Tendulkar is news for a while. But when you keep repeating that over 18 months, as the principal speaker mentioned, news discovered or introduced for the first time is actual news. If you keep repeating it, it becomes entertainment for the public. All I'm saying is, I'm not trying to undermine Maria Sharapova. All I'm trying to say is that the Indian people and that the population in general wants entertainment. And that is why they're talking about it. It's not me that's talking about it. It's because it's entertaining and I know about it. Entertaining to the public. That is what we are talking about.
Thank you so much. We shall now move to the supporting speaker of the opposition, Kadet Harshvardhan Singh. Please take the dais.
Check.
With the permission of the chair. A new sense is really a sense of what is important, of what is vital, with some color and life what people are interested in. That's journalism, the side proposition. Greetings to the House today. I being the second speaker of side opposition, I'm here to uphold the resolution, to oppose the resolution that this House believes journalism is more about entertainment than news. The second speaker of the side proposition talked of all the methods. I will give you a simple analogy. That is the method to serve a meal. You garnish the meal with a lot of things. That is entertainment, ladies and gentlemen. But the food which you are having, that is news. And the proposition denies that we are not having the food and we are just looking at the garnishing of the food. And that is the matter of the fact, ladies and gentlemen. It is the food which is important, not the garnishing. And that is how the purpose of journalism is served. The opposition has been throwing red herrings. The proposition has been throwing red herrings at the side opposition by talking the importance and less importance of entertainment in journalism. Let me tell you, there is a thick line of difference between being more about something. Journalism is more about news because it is serving the purpose, and you also agreed that yes, journalism is a method of spreading news, and which is the purpose in itself. That is why, ladies and gentlemen, I say that journalism is more about spreading news than entertainment. Like the first speaker clearly defined, that I'm going to talk about infotainment, which is an amalgamation of the words information and entertainment. Information reaching by the means of entertainment. So what is important? What is important? What is reaching to you, ladies and gentlemen? It is the information which is reaching, and which is what we are proposing. We as the side opposition are proposing. So it is like providing the purpose. Now, with all due respect, I would like to appreciate the way the quiz master, sir, conducted the Boulogne Lees quiz. It was so enthralling and it was so entertaining. But what was the purpose? The purpose was to learn. And that purpose was served. Similarly, ladies and gentlemen, entertainment is just the garnishing of the food which we are having. So is the food which is important, which gives us energy, or the garnishing which the Thai proposition keeps looking at? We tell you, ladies and gentlemen, the Thai cave rescue. The Thai cave rescue was brought in limelight by journalism, and it was because of journalism that countries around the world got activated and those people were rescued. We tell you, ladies and gentlemen, of the Nirbhaya rape case. Nirbhaya was served justice through journalism. We tell you of the Kathua rape case. It was brought to limelight with the help of journalism. We tell you of the Kedarnath victim relief fund, which was raised due to journalism. We tell you about the Nepal earthquake victim relief fund, which was raised due to journalism. And it might sound so entertaining to the side proposition, but it doesn't sound to me, because it is so gory and so ghastly, and which was brought to limelight by journalism. I don't know how the side proposition clearly denies the fact that it was not journalism that brought all these news, and justice was provided by journalism. Ladies and gentlemen, I would just like to ask you, if it is not journalism, if it is not news, and if it is only entertainment, then where are we headed? Thank you.
Thank you so much, Karet Singh. You elaborated in your speech the keyword left by your principal speaker, infotainment, and you gave us again lots of examples of the Thai rescue, the Nirbhayas, and the Kathua cases, and carried forward the speech for the opposition. So at this point, I would like to invite, yes, a few refutation questions.
So my question to you is that, do journalists pander to the society?
Would you repeat the question, please?
Sure, sir. So my question to you is, do journalists pander to society?
This is what the side opposition has been trying to convey. I am saying that journalism, at the risk of their lives, are not like, oh, we are going to garnish our news with this sort of a platter. We are going to present this like this. Ladies and gentlemen, the journalism with the sole purpose of practicing journalism in its spirit have the aim of spreading news and not just serving it like the side proposition says. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Sir, my second question, ma'am, if I may ask it. So you talked about how these were brought to the limelight. Sir, don't you know about the millions of entertainment cases that are brought to the limelight every day and are talked about and debated upon for a few weeks at an end?
The millions of entertainment cases are in itself a news, and they are brought to limelight by journalism, so there is no point arguing that what those entertainment cases are all about. They in itself are a news, ladies and gentlemen, and that is why the side proposition's case falls flat on their face. Thank you.
So at this juncture, both the principal and supporting speakers have put forth their speeches and taken this debate to its climax. I am very anxious to know how the third speakers are going to sum up, I mean, not really sum up, but give the final arguments for their sides. And the good news is that this debate has gone ahead right up till this point without any eventuality of foul language, bad behavior, and I'm very happy with this standard of debating. So now I invite the third speaker of the proposition, Arnav Gurnani, to give us his final argument.
A very good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. The topic under fire for today's debate states that this House believes that journalism is more about entertainment than news. And I, as the third speaker of side proposition, stand here firmly proposing the motion. Now, to start off, I would like to deconstruct the arguments provided by side opposition today. Now, first of all, they came up and said that we neglected patriotic newspapers like the Kesari. Well, sir, when we're talking about this debate, when we're debating on this topic, we are talking about today's modern society in this case, where freedom fighters have already gone. We cannot talk about it in today's debate. Furthermore, there is a reason that these newspapers are dying. Since news broadcasting is also evolving, since society is evolving, there is a reason that newspapers and radio broadcasting means aren't as popular anymore. And that is what we're trying to convey. Entertainment is what sells news these days. Furthermore, they came and talked about the purpose of journalism. Well, first of all, we never said that journalists do not spread news. We are saying that entertainment is spread more by these same journalists as opposed to actual news. Well, when they say that the purpose of journalism is to sell news, agreed. However, the purpose is to sell. Remember, ladies and gentlemen. And in today's society, how will they sell the news? They will sell the news through entertainment. That is what my speakers have been talking about. Packaged through entertainment. Furthermore, they talked about the fact that entertainment spreads the news. Well, exactly, since they conceded to the argument already, the purpose is to sell. Thank you so much, side of opposition. Furthermore, they came up and talked about the fact that information is actually being spread by these news channels. Well, it is not just information. That is what side proposition is trying to say. Like my principal speaker has already mentioned, if a 10-hour broadcast show is broadcasted, out of those 7 hours is about useless, insignificant stuff that just entertains and appeals the people, not actual news. Furthermore, they talked about information being spread, right? Exactly. Well, we aren't living in a utopian world. Now, here is where utopia comes in, ladies and gentlemen. According to them, the purpose of a journalist is to spread news, and that is what he will do. Understand that he needs to sell it in order for that broadcasting company to run. How is that happening? When it is encapsulated with the entertainment factor. And that is why to sell the news more, they need to focus more on the entertainment factor, and that is why our point has been proved today. They talked about the rape cases. Well, exactly how long did those rape cases stay in the news? That is what we as side proposition are asking. As opposed to the Kardashian wedding or the royal wedding, which according to the people is entertaining, and that is why the people demand it. Now moving on to some of my own constructives, ladies and gentlemen. Like I've already talked about, the evolution of news. Exactly. Today we demand a media. Today we news forms where people are entertained. And that is why entertainment is what is remembered. If I read a normal line or a line which is praised in a way to entertain me, I will remember the line which entertains me. And that is why the public demand is entertainment. And that is why the news broadcasters focus more on entertainment. Then when we talk about newer forms of news broadcasting and we think about online news. Well, exactly, ladies and gentlemen, since the existing of online news is an actual reality. Well, what does that provide to the people? When a news broadcaster through an online broadcasting service has posted a certain news and people are not reacting well to it, they understand that it hasn't struck a chord with the people. And that is why, since they have the option of editing that news, they change it in a way to attract people, which further proves that entertainment is what sells instead of actual news. With that, ladies and gentlemen, I'm very, very proud to propose. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Arna. You carried forward the central argument of the proposition and brought into focus yet again the word sell and also took up lots of points from the side opposition and refuted them in your speech. Now I give this opportunity to the opposition.
Mr. Speaker, you talked about how long did the rape cases stay on the news channel. Yesterday I saw Kathua rape case, Unnao rape case and many more continuously providing the knowledge to the people about what is happening in a society. Please comment.
Now, sir, when you said that the rape cases are being broadcasted, well, of course they are. However, sir, you have to realize that if we compare the amount of actual news and when we compare the amount that is insignificant and is just entertaining, and that is why it is being broadcasted, we see clearly that these news broadcasting companies are actually focusing much, much more on entertainment value. And that is why they are working to get their ratings higher. I hope that answers your question.
Debates are a form of journalism. Here at this debate, we are given 25 marks for content and 5 marks for delivery. Delivery is entertainment. 25 is content. That is the news. Please comment.
Well, sir, as a matter of fact, in a debate, we are supposed to project our own opinion, which is biased news. Hence, it is not actual news. I hope that answers.
Thank you so much, Arna. I allowed it this time, but next time, please, comment will not be regarded as a question. Please frame a question where the verb comes before the subject. Thank you. All right. Now we move to the third speaker of the opposition, Cadet Dhruv Dahiya.
Doctors take a Hippocratic oath to let their patients live. Military men take an oath to protect their country. But ladies and gentlemen, journalists go into the jaws of death without taking an oath, and just because they had a pinch of entertainment so that the masses can understand, so that the spread of news remains in the entire country, they are here to categorize the whole $300 million industry that acts as a lens between the public and the happenings, ladies and gentlemen, being more about entertainment. Well, good morning, good afternoon to the House at large. Today, I, being the third speaker side, opposition, vehemently oppose the motion that this House believes journalism is more about entertainment than news. Now, ladies and gentlemen, as my previous speakers have already told you, that yes, the entertainment being a part of news does not mean that news is not being sold. They talked about newspapers aiming to sell news. Well, what's the use of selling news if no one buys it? And if you're telling me that people buy entertainment and not news, well, ask a person, what did he hear in Arnab Goswami's debate? Did he hear the flowery words used by Arnab Goswami? Did he hear what he said throughout the course of the debate? Or did he hear what Arnab Goswami did at the end, batted out the topic, and then got it to a conclusion, ladies and gentlemen? You'll get the answer yourself. Now, ladies and gentlemen, they talked about how long do rape cases stay in the newspaper. Well, let me tell you how long do rape cases stay in the newspaper. As I said, you cannot sell unless anyone buys. Well, you ask someone, does he know the exact details of Kim Kardashian's backside, or does he know the actual details of a Nirbhaya rape case, ladies and gentlemen? That is your answer. Now, moving on, ladies and gentlemen, they talked that the past cannot be included in this House. Well, I wear specs so that my vision becomes 6x6, and nowhere in the topic is written that 21st century journalism is more about entertainment than news, ladies and gentlemen. Journalism was there, journalism has brought the truth to us, and journalism will bring the truth to us. Now, ladies and gentlemen, try putting news in rows and columns and try projecting it to the world. There are remote corners of our country that do not understand news without entertainment.
wanted to hear, but he didn't define what was the actual word that was more about, ladies and gentlemen. And at the end of this debate, you shall see why side opposition's point, ladies and gentlemen, holds strong in this debate. Well, if you're telling me that all new journalists today are entertainers, well, actually, I have never heard the murder of an entertainer, but I've only heard the murder of the warriors of truth, being the journalists in today's society, and they propagate journalism, ladies and gentlemen. When is justice? What is justice, ladies and gentlemen? When will justice come? Will it come today? Will it come tomorrow? Will it come next week? Will it come in the next 100 years? We don't know. But when will the truth come? The truth will come in the 2-page article, ladies and gentlemen, that will actually tell the situation. And that is why the truth is what people want. Now, in the end, ladies and gentlemen, the discipline of verification, which the journalism is mainly about, ladies and gentlemen, is what separates journalism from pure entertainment. The topic today is not what journalism has been subjected to, but the topic is what journalism is intended to do. And we as citizens need to ensure that, ladies and gentlemen, the truth is propagated by journalism. And yes, that is why I am proud to oppose the motion. Thank you, and Jai Hind.
Thank you, Karet Dhaiya. Judges, please note that the third speaker of the opposition exceeded the time by 15 seconds. So in your speech, you carry forward the arguments of the opposition and brought in examples of Gauri Lankesh, and at the same time, Arnab Goswami also featured in your speech. So I think we have gone the whole spectrum. And you wound up your speech by stressing on the word about. We know more about than we ever did. So thank you so much for that lovely speech. And that please ended the argument for the opposition. Yes, questions please.
So my first question to you is, are a majority of journalists today going into the jaws of death?
Of course not. Majority of journalists are not going into death. But ladies and gentlemen, majority of journalists, or maybe every journalist, is working hard for the news. And are you telling me that news which he works hard for, he's willing to give it up so that his news can only be portrayed as entertainment? No, ladies and gentlemen, he is working hard so that every last piece of the news, every last piece of information is given out as news to the public and not entertainment. And that is what I mean.
Yes, second question.
Thank you, sir. Now for my second question. Sir, you talked about how it isn't important to sell news if nobody is buying it. Isn't that exactly the point of entertaining and entertainment being added into news?
Well, Mr. Speaker, the answer of your question is in your question. Of course, that's the reason why entertainment is added into news. But that's not the reason, and the news becomes about entertainment, ladies and gentlemen. Entertainment is added so it's propagated, but not the reason why it becomes entertainment.
Thank you. So with that, we come to the end of the argument stage of this debate. And now we look forward to hearing from the opposition, the principal speaker of the opposition, Cadet Tanmay Malik, who will sum up the argument from his side and then rest his case. Thank you.
Enough of past debating, ladies and gentlemen. Good afternoon once again. Let's start point to point. Let's talk of the first speaker from the side of proposition. Now, the first speaker of the side proposition defines news as something which is exactly same. Newspapers have columns which have opinions from analysts. There are editorials that are just opinions which every debater craves for, but they say that is not news, which means that they're 75% of the newspaper is just not of news because they are not exactly, and they are someone's opinions. Second, he says that the journalists who come on the television promote baseless journalism. They are just angry people. Gentlemen and ladies and gentlemen, I agree And I think we all agree that we as debaters too collect facts from internet, from journalist news and reports. And if their journalists are factless, baseless, then should I hope that their facts too are factless and baseless? If yes, then debate is over. Now, the second thing. What the side proposition has failed to understand here is that today news is not only about political issues, news is not only about economics. News can be about entertainment personalities too. The first speaker says that the newspaper or the news article tell him which food to eat, which country is good, where to travel. And these are not information, these are not news, they are only entertainment. Ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you, food only entertains gluttons. Countries only entertain nationalists or chauvinists. Travel only entertains maniac about traveling. And if they still believe that these food, country and travel details must not come, then tomorrow I'll go to journalists and I'll tell them, please don't tell people what to eat, so that tomorrow they have any fruit, any vegetable, and they go and die. Please do not tell them which country to go so that I get a visa of Syria and reach there. Please do not tell which place to travel so that I do not visit the famous Dastar Khwan restaurant of Lucknow and go to any place and then say that the Lucknowi kebab are not good. The third speaker comes and talks that newspapers are dying. There were about only 15 newspapers that we know of the nationalist time. Today there are about 500 plus that I know at least, and there are regional newspapers plus. Now, if these are the status of dying newspapers, then I don't know what will happen once they are growing or having a rebirth. Now, he says that out of 10 hours, there is only 7 hours of entertainment. Please be aware, there is a rule that there is only 30% cap on non-information stuff. And if that cap is there, okay, 30% may be reaching to 40%, but you are making it reach to 70%, which is, I think, even more than double. Now, the second speaker says that Sharapova, a player, a great player, is a fact, not a news. But the first player wants facts in the news, and the second speaker does not want facts in the news. So actually, what do they wish to need? Now, they say that they do not wish to know about that Kate Middleton married the prince, or some event happened, Donald Trump became the president. They want it in a single line. Okay, from tomorrow, I'll tell, start writing 600, 800, 1000 lines, Donald Trump becomes president, Maria Sharapova wins, Federer wins, Djokovic wins. And do not tell, how did you know that Kate Middleton is the Duchess of Cambridge? Didn't that come in the news? Wasn't that article big enough to tell you that? Is that all possible? Duchess of Cambridge, Kate Middleton, married prince, he was the prince of the Buckingham Palace. If this much can come in your one single line, then we'll be information less and we'll reach nowhere in the future. Now, for the summing up purpose, we as the side opposition have clearly told you that we wish to talk about how news is more about, how the journalism is more about news and not more about the entertainment which we are talking of. Entertainment may be a mode of promotion as famous nowadays and is increasing, but the purpose remains news. With this, I stand and would like to oppose the motion wholeheartedly. Thank you.
Judges, please note, Kiret Malik exceeded the time by 15 seconds. So, Kiret Malik ended his speech and put forth his arguments more vehemently, summed up both his side and the points that he refuted or he stands opposed to in the speeches of the proposition. Now, I allow the proposition to sum up and then finally rest the case.
Ladies and gentlemen, if entertainment is the garnish of news, then please explain to me why Arnab Goswami has drowned my pizza in oregano. We have to understand that in our current generation today, when they come up and say that how will they buy unless they sell, exactly our point. They come up and talk about how journalists have such strong ethics that they want to preserve their work and they don't want to pilfer it just by entertainment. Ladies and gentlemen, because they care about their work, because they want it out there, they want it to sell and they want it to be exposed by more people. They came up here and talked about how it is about all venues of journalism, even in the past and even in the future. Well, clearly the speaker, I think, does have 6x6 vision because he forgot a very imperative word of today's debate. Is, and unless my grammar rules have been confused, is still means present. And when we talk about our current generation, that is what news has become. Their entire case was built on utopia. They believe that journalists have ethics. They believe that the media has proper ethics and everybody is law-abiding in the media circles. Frankly, ladies and gentlemen, there are 15,000 celebrities who are being constantly harassed by paparazzis and other people in this media industry who would vehemently disagree with them. When they talk about how most of the journalists do care about it, ladies and gentlemen, that's not what we're even talking about today. When you look at the news aspect of today's generation, when you look about what is actually reasoning for people, you have to understand that it is mostly coated in entertainment and it is mostly what the people will buy. They say that the media decides what the people see and the people don't. And that is the fundamental flaw in their logic. People will only see what they want to see. And that is when we talk about the societal aspect of our generation. When we talk about the evolution of our society, that we understand that our people are now more entertainment hungry. They are more attention hungry. They came up and talked about how newspapers are not dying anymore and newspapers are, because they have 500 newspapers now, they're still going strong. If you look at the rates at which these newspapers are being bought, if you look at the rate in which these newspapers are switching to online platforms, if you look at the rate these newspapers are actually quitting the industry, you will understand why newspapers are dying out. They came up and talked to you about how news is something which is important and news is the only goal of journalism and is the primary goal of journalism. Ladies and gentlemen, to that we'd just like to say that fine, news is important. We recognize that. The media recognizes that. To an extent, even the society recognizes that. But we aren't arguing in a vacuum. We're arguing with context applied to our current society. And in our current society, it isn't just news that is being accepted. It is everything that goes along with news. When we as Side Proposition today came up and told you that we're going to prove this to you with three aspects. The first aspect being the evolution of media. We showed to you how media has evolved, we showed to you how media has changed, and we showed to you how media is now pandering to society. When they come up and say that media does not pander to society, that is where we fundamentally object. If you look at what sells, if you look at what is being talked about, when they talk to us about the specifications of a particular rape case, and when they talk about the Kim Kardashian's backside, well, ladies and gentlemen, the sad reality of our world is that more people care about that now, and more people are aware about that now. If you look at what is being shared constantly on social media, it isn't always about outrage created in the country. It is also about what is entertaining, what is new, what is fresh, what is trendy. These days, news organizations don't just care about information, don't just care about the news. They also care about the fads, they also care about the trends, they also care about getting their message to the public. And because the opposition believes that news is now equivalent to information, well, frankly, that's news to me. We, as Side Proposition, came up today with a simple belief, proving a fact that in our society, the media isn't what they bring it out to be. The media isn't ethical. You have to understand that in our money-grabbing society, in our attention-hungry society, in our society where everybody wants to be the top broadcaster, the top news network, the best channel, entertainment is what is more important to them than news. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, I am extremely proud to propose. Thank you.
Judges, please note the principal speaker for the proposition exceeded the time by 10 seconds. And the principal speaker proposition, undeterred in his views, proposed the motion for the House today. And may I say that they fought tooth and nail, or should I say they fought preposition and verb. It's an English teacher's delight to hear that every word was turned upside down during this debate. And of course, you both did a great job of it. It's going to be a tough task ahead for the judges to decide what side wins, the preposition side or the verb side. So may I ask the judges to please retire to their room and deliberate upon what all was spoken here today and decide whether the motion stands or it stands defeated. So maybe please escort the judges before I open the house for the four speakers of each side. Great. So now as the judges decide on what happens, yes. Yes, please. I was about to say that. Thank you so much for your graciousness, both teams. And this is what is healthy spirit of competition. So before I invite the fourth speakers to carry forward this debate and engage with the house, may I challenge you to not use backside in your speeches now and let the backside rest for some time. It's amazing what Kim Kardashian can do to even school debates, you know. So let the little boy speeches now be grown up, and let's see how you can hold the fort without Kim Kardashian, please. And of course, her backside. So may I please call the fourth speaker for the proposition, Aman Agarwal, and declare this debate is open to the house.
A very good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Fake news, primetime news, debates going on for hours, Nick Jonas and Priyanka Chopra getting into a relationship being broadcasted for 5 days, the royal wedding being broadcasted for a month. Everything is relevant. Everything is unbiased information, new piece of information. With all of this, is not entertainment, ladies and gentlemen. It is just news. Ladies and gentlemen, the side opposition talked about purpose of journalism. I tell you, obviously, the purpose of journalism is providing information, is spreading information. But all of this news, all of this information, without being encapsulated, without being surrounded by entertainment, without being surrounded by the layers of entertainment, will not be accepted by today's society. Today's society wants entertainment. They'll not accept anything unless entertainment is infused into it. What they want today is entertainment, ladies and gentlemen. That is why it sells. That is why this news doesn't sell. Newspapers. They talked about patriotic newspapers which were relevant in the past. But understand, ladies and gentlemen, why are these newspapers dying? Because of the very reason they don't provide entertainment. They provide basic, simple news which people do not want. Unless there is a story backed up, unless there is a case around it, they don't want it. They want something with which they can get attracted to. That is entertainment. And ladies and gentlemen, I'm very, very proud to propose today. Thank you.
All right, that was short and sweet. Yes, the other side, fourth speaker before I open the house. Karet Agam.
Well, as we are talking about news, the good news is I'm going to be short, and there's no bad news. Well, today's topic was actually, what we see is that said proposition ignored a large number of news which is presented on a daily channel. If the day is divided into 24 hours, does all the 24 hours news channels reflect Bollywood news? Or is it more about our national heroes? Or is it more about our national events which are occurring? They ignore the news when the news channels talk about militants being killed by army jawans. They ignore the news wherein the army, wherein the air force are given a huge tribute. They ignore the news wherein Prime Minister Narendra Modi or any other cabinet minister gives lectures, gives knowledge and impart education to many of the common masses. That is the major proportion of news which we see in today's scenario. But they ignored it because they believe that just like them, everyone is just focused about the 2 hour premiere of this Bollywood news which comes up. Well, moving on to another thing, they talk about entertainment selling. Entertainment sells, but what does it sell? News. Today's topic was about, and there's a huge difference between more about and more important, more responsible.
They themselves talk about the two things are going hand in hand, but then they say that no, it's not more about. Thank you.
Yes, so may I invite people on the floor to please come forward and express their views. Yes, you see a lady there. Yes, please. Please state your name and then whether you propose or oppose the motion. You have to switch on the mic.
Yes. Sorry. My name is Medha Rajesh Singh and I'll be speaking against the motion. Just a small continuation to what the fourth speaker came up here and said. But before that, I would like to say that today's side proposition has really undermined the intelligentsia of today's present generation and the society on large when they say that we expect more entertainment than real news. Well, sir, you're wrong here. And also your entire focus has been about how there is more entertainment than news. We agree that there is a small section of journalism, which is entertainment journalism, which focuses on Bollywood and, you know, like social media celebrities like Kim Kardashian, etc. So they focus on that news, and that news in some way is more about entertainment than real news. But then the debate today was about how news and journalism in general and what is the purpose of that. So I feel that today they have failed to prove how journalism on the whole is becoming all about entertainment, whereas only a certain section of it is about that. And today, sir, if your newspaper's main headline is about the backside of a certain person, then you really need to change your newspaper. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Yes, I see another hand there at the back. Yes, please come forward.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Sadvik Pandey, and I'm from this school only. The topic for today's Under Fire is journalism is more about entertainment than news. I agree with the argument of the second speaker of side proposition. Prince William got married, but to make the news more interesting, they print the facts about the cost of the suit, the cost of the ring. I would like to ask the side opposition, what is the use of this type of information? Secondly, about journalism. The word journalism means that collecting, compiling and broadcasting news. The third word, broadcasting. Broadcasting can also be done without entertainment. We can obtain entertainment by going to cinemas and watching movies. But what will be the difference between a news channel and a movie? Also about the news, they are giving the spicy information about the situation of the condition. News is just about the real facts. About the real facts. My main objective is to lessen the entertainment and from useless facts and to increase the content of useful facts, also known as the authentic news. Here I would like to rest my case. Thank you.
What class are you in? All right. Well, he's very objective. What class are you in? All right. We do see a future debate here. Yes, please. Lovely there.
All right. So I'm Shiji. There's a little piece of information I want to share with you. When I did my journalism and mass communication, we were taught two terms. One was journalism. Journalism meant reporting facts which culminate into news, what a person needs to know. For example, if you're preparing for an IAS exam, you need to know just the facts. So you will read the news, you will read the first page of the news, right? A sports person who wants to know about the sports will read the last page. That would be news for him. There's another terminology which is called yellow journalism, right? Yellow journalism is something which we were restricted or told not to follow at all because that meant all the entertainment part of the news. So if Narendra Modi becomes the prime minister, by what margin he won, which constituency he belongs to, and what was his mandate, that would be journalism. That he had a wife earlier, that he did not marry her, that he sold tea before, and all that which amounts to entertainment now is yellow journalism. Having said that, in our time we had 1 hour of news in a day, 1 hour of news recitation. So that means the news would be bare facts. Today you have 24/7 a channel giving you the same news, so they are not going to survive until and unless they adhere to all the details, which gory details, which may be of any news of any meaning to you. But as long as they entertain and they keep the TRP working, that's how they continue. Thank you.
Thank you so much. All right, I'll invite 2 more short excerpts or speeches. Yes. So, yes, please. I mean, you could come. I think you've been here. And then maybe after him, child after him. First he's coming in, then you come in. So you can come forward.
Good afternoon. I'm Ayush Jain from Nirja Modi School. And here I'm here today to argue with side opposition. Basically, I'm against the motion. So first of all, I feel like the example of Kim Kardashian that the side proposition has used is in fact news. Like talking about the Duchess of Cambridge's backside is also news because of the simple reason. Firstly, because it is a royal family's wedding. It is a wedding in the royal family. It is a wedding of the person third in line for the crown of Britain, for the crown of the United Kingdom. So simply telling that and giving all the details about the wedding make the public feel connected to the government, to the monarchy of their own country, and making them feel connected towards their government is the whole point of journalism, ladies and gentlemen, because of the simple fact that they're telling their country about news, about what is happening in their country and what is important, because the marriage of the person third in line for the crown is a very important news. And second of all, I believe the side proposition has somewhat failed to prove their burden, because I feel when I saw their own, when I heard their case, I felt like they're talking about how journalism also entails entertainment, and but not that journalism entails entertainment more than news. The simple fact that they're quoting news with entertainment shows that the primary focus of journalism is to spread news, whatever means they use. And that is what I say is journalism. Second of all, the speaker before me, ma'am, said that Narendra Modi's wife, talking about Narendra Modi's wife is also news. I absolutely agree with it, because it makes this country feel connected to the prime minister of this nation. It makes them feel connected to the leader of this nation. It makes them feel connected to the person who's going to represent the whole nation in the international communities, ladies and gentlemen. And that is a very, very important factor in today's world, because as we've seen, what history has taught us, that people have revolted against their leaders because they did not know them well, because they did not know their actions well, they did not understand them. And ladies and gentlemen, the journalism telling about their leaders, giving details and giving news coated with entertainment, it is basically adapting to the society and still spreading news, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.
Thank you so much. At this juncture, I'm so happy to know that I'm not married to a king or to the Prime Minister, because I really don't want to stay connected to so many people in that way. So talking about backsides is connection. So I'm so glad. Anyway, I am sure you meant otherwise. So that little boy wanted to come in. I think he's got a speech prepared. Let's listen to him, please. Please help him with the mic.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon to one and all present here. I am Ritik Saxena and I am a boarder here. I am from Jaipur. Today's topic for debate is journalism is more about entertainment other than news? If you go back home and watch a news channel, what you will find? 25 minutes of news and 45 minutes of advertisement. Well, an advertisement is something which promotes a sale of product, which is also called commercial advertisement. This form of advertisement is promoting materialistic way of life. These make the people believe that happiness is bought by buying products. These advertisements target the youth, especially boys and girls. Girls who are dark in complexion and are too fat to fit in the society get upset and feel depressed when they see the ad of Fair and Lovely or any beauty cream. And if you talk about boys who see the ads of bodybuilders, they get really upset when they see their muscles. So they start to take drugs just to grow up buffed up muscles. Well, a news channel is something that awares people. So are these news channels awaring people by selling these products like Maggie, Pepsi, which even these news channels also know that it's unfit for the people? Thank you.
Thank you. So that was the last speaker from the audience. I'm sure we can go on talking about this endlessly. However, I would like to sort of close this debate with some points that I have in mind. Let me start at the outset by congratulating both of you all for doing a fabulous job, because please understand, one side is proposition and one side is opposition. And sometimes the topic under discussion can be tricky, you know, especially if that topic in this country revolves around patriotism, Bharat Mata. Journalists also are regarded as crusaders and of course, the army. So these are tricky topics to discuss in a country which was once colonized. And these people came forward in all forms as freedom fighters. So it is upon us, the post-colonial India, to share this burden of colonization. So does that mean we cannot speak? Does that mean we don't have a voice? Of late we saw, you know, all these episodes of sedition, which I feel is a draconian law. All right, I was born into this country. All right, I really have tremendous respect for the armed forces. However, does that mean I lose my voice when I speak up against some atrocities they may have committed or against the media without failing a person like Gauri Lankesh? So these topics come with a burden of something known as deification. Do you understand deification, everyone? Deification means making someone larger than life. For example, a mother is deified. A woman is in India is regarded as a deity. So if you speak up against Mata, it is seditious. However, that same perpetrator is allowed to rape and violate the modesty of that woman. So we live in a perplexing duality in this country, where at least women are always at a loss, what is it that they are supposed to do? So if I sit here and I wear inappropriate clothes for this juncture, that makes me bad. But a man can watch me in an inappropriate way and get away with saying that she allowed it or she asked for it. You know? So why? Because I am the deity. I am the bloody deity here. I was supposed to be the Mata. And A man doesn't have the burden of being the Pitta or some god. So men get away with being lesser mortals and the deity suffers because she has to be on her guard every now and then. Similarly, a journalist also has undergone that process of deification because people who spread news against the Raj, the British Raj, were killed. And now journalism has born of that tremendous deity. Does that make all journalists good? Can we not speak about journalism? By speaking against certain form of journalism, are we failing the likes of Gauri Lankesh, who actually died in the process of collecting news? So I understand the tricky topic that we have against us. And I really do can congratulate both teams. Because, you know, the fight begins, but the way it tapers, the boundaries do get blurred. And in the end, when we notice the speeches, and in all debates I've been noticing these speeches, whether it has been at the school level or college level, definitions really do start becoming blurred. Because you are faced with examples from each side that are actually piercing. And then you try to redefine and you have to stand on your own. Therefore, we also saw today that desperate attempt to actually hang on to parts of speech, you know, and I think that was brilliantly done. You know, maybe because, you know, I'm particularly sort of fancy grammar in a debate. And again, this debate proved to us, no matter what side we are on, we will never stop giving in to the anthropological gaze. Let me give you this term again. Now, when I am reporting a rape, a journalist's duty is to report a rape. But what is that thin line? Is he glamorizing the rape? So he may say I'm glamorizing it or not glamorizing it because I have to show the suffering to get the people to get angry. But do the people have the right to peep into that person's life? And I'm saying a person, because allow me to remind you, any person can get raped. It's not only the privileged right of a woman. The numbers, of course, are skewed. So this line, are we crossing that line? So I hope that some of you would actually bring up this glamorization that was involved. What we did to the Kathua rape case is shameful. As a nation, we should feel collective shame. Because our leaders shamed us by crediting or discrediting the facts of the case. So for no country actually allows the rape victim or survivor, we can give glamorous terms, we can say survivor, but we don't believe that person is a survivor. So no country discredits the alleged victim or survivor, whatever you want to call it. But our leaders not only discredited that little person there, they failed that person. The moment the news media discredits a story, that's a big deal. Then people start again talking about it. So we are not over here actually debating about yellow journalism, as ma'am rightly defined it for us, or champagne journalism. We were actually debating the blurring lines between giving off facts or mixing them with some sort of opinion which is not actually allowed at that moment. Having said that, I would not say opinions do not make news. When we were in school or the era we were talking about, opinions actually put news in perspective. Editorial articles are extremely important news because they allow commoners like us to understand tricky details. The fight over here, I feel, should have been on this gaze, the anthropological gaze, peeping into things that you should not peep into. Peeping into a rape victim's life, you may call it, you know, awareness, because people have to respond, but everyone knows what rape is. Everyone knows the ghastly narrative that follows, the horrors of the rape. Do they need to peep into another victim's life to actually talk about it? So this glamorization, this deification process has to end if the country has to move towards actual democratic functioning. A mother should not be glamorized or deified. She can have feelings of her own. She can have a life of her own. So if a mother has a life of her own and the media shows it as a bad mother, I think the media has failed all mothers. So was the reporting correct? Yes, it is correct. But presentation, the gaze, is not correct. Our media have to come of age. Someone talked about BBC. Our media have to actually come of age. And those prime time news anchors should actually be publicly flogged sometime for the way they actually fail causes by this gaze or by talking about details that can act, that should be thrown out of the window. And then persecuting a person on his character. So soon news goes down and character assassination starts coming up. So if the person is the son of someone, the father also is involved, mother also is involved. So this gaze is not or should not be allowed. And I think I do not claim to know a lot of the Western media, but responsible media is this. So yellow journalism is allowed. If you are a paparazzi, fine, that's your job. Of course, you can't go ahead and kill Princess Diana again, but that's your job. So those pages are separate, but within actual authentic journalism, have the media failed us by subjecting us to that gaze? Because we all, by birth, Freud said, we all love to gaze, we all love to peek into others' lives. That's what we end up doing. So yes, we may want to stay connected with our Prime Minister, we may want to stay connected with Prince William, especially I did want to because I had a huge crush on him, but what the media did to his wife, you know, but we have no business of staying connected to them to that extent, you know, so we have to let them be. So gazing into the physique, physical feature, clothes, what is showing, what is not showing, how her dress showed this and did not show that, that of course is something we have to stop doing in mainstream media. So anthropological gaze should have been the topic of discussion, and you know, and we should have probably debated about whether our media has come of age or not. And I'm just sharing it for future, really. I mean, at this level that we are on, I actually love your debating. Your points were very well collated. You debated really professionally, if I may say so. You caught onto each other's arguments, mistakes, glitches, every fact you hung onto with your life. That's superb debating. And my job as a chairperson is to add to your debating. So I hope I have fulfilled that job and, you know, give you more facts for the future because it's not ending here. You should go into college and become national level debaters and actually make your city proud and your school proud. So thank you so much. And you all were a lovely audience. I love hearing your views as well. And good luck to you for the future. I see someone's there with the results. Great. So please. We all know we have amidst us Raja Sahab Mahmoodabad, and we've all heard lots and lots about sir from, and we've grown up, you know, reading about the Mahmoodabad property disputes. In fact, that was news in our time and it still is, and sir has lived it all. And at this moment, I think a few words from you would be.
I hope my voice is neither too jarring nor inaudible. It may oscillate between the two. However, good afternoon, Ms. McFarlane, Principal, Vice Principal, Ms. Narula, and Mrs. Malik. I should remember we were talking about the debate just now. So I don't need to make any speech or anything about it. What was said by the principal and Surabhi is a very small part of my life, actually. I'm very grateful that I have been privileged to have a great education in terms of a variety of languages, in terms of love for the literature and poetry of that. Having said that, I wish to make only two observations here, and they pertain to the fact that there was a debate here, and that young people are endeavoring to debate and to make their views heard, persuasive in terms of content, in terms of delivery. And I'm happy to say that both the sides, I was extremely impressed by them, by both the sides. And I have a hope that one day some of these young people will enter a world, I say some, please note, because I can't say all, some will enter a world which decides our fate as a country and as a state. In other words, I have been MLA twice from Ahmedabad and for the Congress. I have had very fundamental differences with the Congress and have been tolerated for it and am not grateful, because I think I was right and I'm still to be convinced that I'm wrong. However, the level of debate that I saw both in the House and which I saw when I used to visit Parliament was not particularly edifying, if I may use that word. And I think it may not really reflect the best that this nation has to offer in terms of vision, rhetoric, in terms of content, in terms of substance. And unfortunately, there are a few people who, unfortunately, there are only a few people who can do this. The second thing which was said about, this is enough about the, in other words, in one sentence, I hope some of you enter politics. Our country needs you, all of you and all of you there. Because a space has been actually taken which does not give credit to the greatness of this country. The second thing which I would like to say is about the topic, and that is very, very important. And I think journalism must entertain, but journalism must be about news as well. And I think in order to increase TRP ratings, people have begun to mistake the studio for a stage or a film set where they can act and behave in a certain manner and attract attention of the world. And they do attract attention. What happens as a consequence is the actual, and they're not all the channels. I don't wish to name channels. I don't wish to name individuals. But there are channels who endeavor, who try, who struggle, who strive to actually improve the manner in which news is given to you by others, both in Hindi and in English. And I must say, I'm very deeply moved by the channels which are in Hindi. Some of them outrank the channels in English in terms in two ways. One, in terms of the courage and
That is all I need to say. Owning of channels and owning of newspapers, unfortunately, is a reality. But channels like the BBC, I'm sure there are others, Al Jazeera with some English, not Arabic. Arabic is different. But the English Al Jazeera, perhaps, but certainly the BBC, is a kind of thing with defects, but it is something that we could think about. Once again, I would like to thank Mr. McFarland, Dr. McFarland, the principal of La Martinia, and the boys here, people on the stage, Surabiji, for having allowed me to speak to you and to express my thoughts. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for your speech. And we could go on listening to you forever. We have a very pressing announcement now to make. And as a chairperson, it is my proud privilege to declare the results today, having been in the midst of some amazing arguments that I have. The motion in the House today has been lost. Congratulations, Rashtriya Indian Military College, Dehradun. You are the winners today. The opposition wins. I'm sure the boys at La Martinia can do a better job with their applause, the boys. Well, maybe now the boys have more reason to clap because the best speaker today is the third speaker of the proposition, Arnab Gurnani. There you go. So congratulations, both of you. You really did know one would win and one would lose. So I think the results are quite balanced. I have the sheet before me. It was a very tough job, and I can see that through the scores. So it would be unfair to say that one side really lost or the other side really won. Great job. However, we have clear winners, which is the Rashtriya College, Military College. Thank you so much. I declare the debate closed.
I'd like to use this opportunity. Boys, please remain seated. I would like to use this opportunity to thank our chairperson, who most effectively has guided this entire debate this afternoon. It is only when we have a chairperson who knows her work that we can actually steer through the arguments and cut through a lot of slab that otherwise builds up. Thank you, Dr. Sahai, for being with us this afternoon. May I once again thank our three judges. Keep in mind that these are the only three people who actually pay attention. The rest of you, okay, you'll nudge each other, you'll have a little whisper, you'll talk about a point which may have been raised and so on. But the three judges at any function such as this, okay, really listen. And it is because of this that we have objective and unbiased judgment. Okay? Thank you, Ms. Narullah. Thank you, Mrs. Malik. And thank you, Mr. Suleiman Khan, for being with us. Also, thank you for addressing our boys, also on behalf of the judges. We will now move to, I think boys are going for lunch just now. But the boys of La Martinia will remain standing as our invited guests leave the hall. Thank you very much and good afternoon.